You're actually here, Phil.
Yeah. All right. We're on air. What's up, Dan? How are you doing?
I'm good. A lot better than last time, so we'll see a better performance out of me, hopefully. I was a little bit nervous, so it's all good. All gone.
It's all fine. Well, guys, we've got Shoya versus Czech first up here. It is going to be a PVZ. What do you think about these matches today on Stable?
I'm actually quite excited for these ones. I think we got the better group out of A and B today.
Yeah, I think
so, too. Definitely
the
stronger players between both of them.
Shoutouts to Gunrun and Torch for filling in for the beginning part of the day.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, it's very difficult to cast for an entire day of both rounds of Code A, so we had a lot of arranging to do. And
yeah, it was about 10 hours.
Yeah, it's a lot of time. So Shoya, obviously, is a player known for his all-ins, and for good reason. I mean, he's a coach. Yeah. He doesn't have as much time to play in the late game as everyone else does, so he's known for his all-ins. And I think we'll probably see some sort of timing attack out of him in all of these games, most likely.
Yeah. Well, it's the only way to go for him, really. Like you said, he doesn't have enough time. And we're going to go see into the match results. What?
Yeah, he just doesn't have much experience into the mid or late game.
Yeah.
So you can see earlier today's match results. Ready and Dream. Ready, of course, advancing. Lovesick advancing over Creator Prime. Leanok edging out Hope Torture. Hope Torture, I wonder if we'll ever see him again. He's fallen so far. And, of course, Yoda edging out Min in a very interesting series, to say the least.
Very interesting indeed. So we did get the opportunity to watch those broadcasts from the Golem House before we came here.
Yeah.
It's very interesting. And given the fact this is the round of 32, four of those guys now have to come back through the Create 8 qualifiers, something no one wants to do.
Absolutely. That's what's the most important part of today. Today is the day to win. Because if you don't win today, you have to go through the qualifiers again. That's so much harder than anything else.
Yeah.
So it's very important. Now, obviously, you guys can see at the bottom, or today's players, we already talked about Shoya. Noblesse playing against Hero, that should be a good match. Foxlin playing against Hosa, Tassadar, and Ryung will battle it out against Gumiho. Gumiho actually has been getting so much better. I watched him play when he was playing random in the team league, the very first team league. I think he was the very first player even to play. Played for Foyu, still, of course, back then. And he was playing random, and he looked a little weak. Now he looks anything but weak. He actually qualified yesterday for FX Open's $5,000 invitational event.
We did.
So, all right, there is Czech. And he said, it's said of him that he practiced a lot, but recently he's not doing well. And actually, one of the girls here at the studio came up to me and asked me, who do you think's going to take this match? And I said, well, the thing is, Czech practices a lot more than Shoya, but recently he just hasn't been doing well. And that pretty much sums it up there in that statement.
Sometimes that does happen to some players, though. You get into the mindset of you're not playing well, so then you just fall. It just happens that you don't do it. You really need to keep that positive attitude, otherwise it just snowballs down. Some people don't come back from it.
Yeah. I worry for Czech, because if he loses here today, he's going to have to re-qualify, and I'm not sure if this guy can do it.
I don't think anyone can really has a positive chance of getting through those qualifiers.
Well,
you cannot look at a player in that bracket and go, that guy's going to qualify.
Yeah, you just really can't. And if you haven't been to the qualifiers, you just don't even know what it's really like there. It's so tense. Now, his opponent, of course, is Shoya. He's a very confident player and has very strong attack timing, according to that little note there at the bottom. That's very true. He actually is really known for his timing attacks. He basically has a watch on his hand and just lives by it. No, it's actually in his brain. He doesn't need a watch. He actually knows what time it is any time of the day. And, when he's like, someone asks you after he wakes up in the morning, he's like, oh, how long have you been awake? He's like, oh, it's about the timing where I would take my third. It's been about that long.
He does prepare very well for these events as well, though, given the fact that he's a coach of Foyu at the time. It's really good to practice what you preach.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, we have a lot of players like that. We have The Wind, who's also a coach, who, he plays, he dropped out of Codes recently, but he's still really good. There's obviously Slayer's Boxer, who's not only a talent scout and manager, but also a coach. And still, he plays and succeeds. He did okay in the team league. He had his little run there, and no one really expected that of him, especially because he's got some injuries right now, so it's very difficult for him to play. So there are a lot of these kind of coaches.
Yeah, it is disappointing when players of that caliber do that, because it is very difficult to balance the coaching, because you need to help your players out as well. But looking at these maps here, we're going to start off with Zelnaga Fortress, going into Crevasse, and if the third game is needed, onto Metalopolis.
Yeah, I think Czech can do this here today. It's very important for him, because Shoya is one of those players whose mentality has always been strong and he never gets shouted. He used to talk to himself because he was nervous, but since then, sometimes he does talk to himself occasionally, but he's just so confident. that he was able to break through the Codec qualifiers. When I saw him there, I watched him play his game three in his qualifying match, and he was so excited, and he was so pumped the entire time. I just don't see that kind of energy from Czech. And of course, Choya had to re-qualify after getting lost, or after getting knocked out in the round of 32 last time. If Czech gets knocked out here, I just don't know if he can do it on stable.
Yeah, I believe actually the live stream that was run by CSN of the Codec qualifiers actually captured the final moments of that game for Choya too, and it was a little bit happy.
It was. It was pretty excited. Well, the countdown is starting. The map is loading. It is going to be Zelnaga Fortress, so get ready. Do you think Czech's going to take this one?
I don't know. Let's find out.
Let's find out here at the GSL Codec in just a minute. Map is loading. I'm serious. I wouldn't lie to you guys.
Once the map actually loads?
Once it loads.
All right.
It's going to happen in a second. Don't worry. They're mining. I see them down there. The probes are going back and forth.
It's very frustrating when that happens when you're online as well. You don't know who's actually killed
it.
And there we go.
All right, over here at the top left, a player on the team Prime was really good in the beta in the early stages of release, but recently has not been doing as well. A really good Zerg player. Can he beat Choya here today?
Mic check, 1, 2, 1, check a Prime B.
What?
That was actually so awesome.
Oh my gosh.
All right, so that's Czech Prime, of course. His opponent down here at the bottom right, who appears to be doing a Forge Fast Expand, is...
Choya!
There's Gisato. He actually lives in the GOM house with us. He's a great guy. Really funny. He has a great personality. So
he's very quiet, actually, as well. You would not
expect him to be a commentator.
No,
he is so quiet. He sits in his room and he ladders, and he practices hard, I have to say.
It's good that he puts that much effort into it as well. He doesn't cast as often as a lot of other people, but he really puts his all into it. I really respect that.
The Korean commentators really do. They actually spend so much time preparing for their casts, not only by playing, but thinking about what they're going to talk about. They do a lot of different stuff, so...
Yeah.
I got to say, pretty impressed by them. Right now, we are going to have a speed link expand for Czech. He has gotten that gas. The spawning pool is being made, and Choya is going to go for a quick 15 Nexus. Mm-hmm.
Well, Czech is in the position to punish him for this, as he did get his 14 pull. He doesn't have speed, though. He doesn't have a gas for the speed just yet, so it's very difficult to actually come in and deal with the cannon timings. But if you notice it early, you can actually try and all in them with the roaches off the one base.
Yeah, this map actually really does allow you to use that Forge Fast Expander quite well. He went for a Nexus first, of course, so it's not technically a Forge Fast Expand, but of course he is going to have to use that Forge and the cannons anyways. He's got a pretty nice wall off down there, and if with good cannon positioning, it's actually a pretty easy map to defend.
Yeah, but it also, like you were saying, it does come down to good map positioning. We saw in the GSTL last Thursday, I believe it was Violet versus Alicia, the amazing SimCity he had there. Violet was first coming across the map, it did not look like he was going to lose at all, and then the beautiful control by Alicia really punished him there. But he is going to get a good scout on what's going on with his Overlord coming across now.
Now, the reason he canceled that cannon, most likely, is that he wants it to be behind a gateway. He's going to put it in between that Nexus and the pylon. And that way, it doesn't get surrounded. But actually, he's going to make a cannon here, which is even more surroundable. So, I'm not entirely sure his decision-making there.
I'd say he's trying to defend the actual...
There he goes. You'll see it. Get a shot of it there. He's going to block that cannon off. It's a little bit unusual because, you know, like, you and I don't really play on this map very often. It's a newer map. It's a GSTL map. You don't play it on the ladder, so...
Yeah. He'd also probably want to be trying to cover the pylon right at the very back to stop him coming around the back to harass his probes as well. He's going to have to back off because that cannon's built now.
The hatchery is going up for Czech at the natural. The Zergling speed is finishing up. He's still not mining from his extractor at all. He just put one harvester inside, so he's slowly starting to get that gas mining up if he wants to use it. Meanwhile, Choya has added his first gas. He started his second one.
The frustrating part for Czech now would be, what is Choya going to do next?
Exactly.
He's going to have a lot of different options. You've got your Stargate openers, you've got your 5-7 gates. There's so many different ways he can do it, and it's good a fact that he has that Overlord in a really nice position.
Now, taking a third base on this map is relatively difficult for both Protoss and Zerg on this map. It's kind of far away from your natural. There's a little bit of an extended walkway there. Hiding a third base is much better, I think. And speaking of hiding a third base, what's that over there on the bottom left of the map? You'll get a shot of it in a second. There it is. So Czech has actually decided to take a hidden base. He was listening to me. He's actually cheating.
We have seen it quite a bit on this map, though. A lot of Zergs do like to take those hidden third bases.
Yeah. Because with that third base, there are two line of sight blockers, so it's very easy. I don't want to say very easy, but it's much easier to defend. Hold that thought. Zerglings are going to come in here and target down a probe. Definitely worth it, two Zerglings for a probe. But as I was saying, that third base location has those line of sight blockers. Looks like it is going to be a Stargate. Czech does not see this, though.
The one spot he hasn't seen inside that base, it's very unfortunate for him. It'll come down to, getting another probe. Has to run away from that Zealot in the middle of the map, forcing his map control out a little bit. Czech doesn't seem like he wants to make anything other than drones at this point until he knows what to actually create to defend himself.
Yep, that Zelnaga Watchtower in the middle does expire now, so that means that having the center of the map is not going to grant you any vision. Smartly, the Zealot is actually going to go over here and check for the hidden expansion over here at the left side of the map. We get a shot of it in a second. He is going to see that Czech has made that hatchery, and it looks like Czech is going to deflect that Zealot. Zealot not going to be able to do any sort of harassment.
The downside to the way that it's progressed on this map is at first, a lot of Zergs were trying to take that third base, which is actually expanding, nicely caught with the Zealot here. Expanding towards your opponent, which is absolutely the worst possible thing you could do. They started taking a lot more. Oh, Czech is actually going to see this Stargate now, going to know what's coming out. It is actually going to be a Void Ray. But as I was saying, a lot of Zergs started taking their hidden thirds, and now a lot of Protoss are realizing they take hidden thirds and just check everywhere.
That's exactly right, Unstable. Now we do see a Spore Crawler being made in the main base of Czech. He's starting to prepare for this Void Ray aggression. But smartly, Choya has made a pylon. Like, we got a shot of it earlier. Kind of near that third base, he may try to add some gateways and pressure it, as you do see he's adding three more gateways inside of his main base, as well as the robotics. He may try to hit with some Void Rays. He's got a second Void Ray on the way. He's going to hit with two Void Rays, most likely, and warp in gateway units to deflect the Queens and the Spore Crawlers.
Yeah, it looks like Choya here hunting Overlords around his base. Did manage to find that last one there for Czech. And now he does actually have a couple of options. A, he could go for that third base, which is really out of range for all the Queens. It's going to take them too long to get there to defend themselves. There's only one Queen and two Spore Crawlers there at the moment. Or he could try and fake out Czech and go for his natural, where none of the defenses is most likely to be.
That's actually a really good point. I like that you say that. Or he could just take his own third, be very aggressive, and never really attack his opponent. Maybe scare him a little bit, maybe pressure a little bit with some units.
We have a Warp Prism.
That is unusual.
It is. Perhaps a flank coming in at the natural, as well as dropping a few Zealots up in the main. A lot of Zergs do get flustered when the multi-attacks come through like that.
Yeah, so Choya does have a bunch of Void Rays. He's got three of them. Moving around the map, he's trying to find Overlords wherever he can. And these Zerglings, you may be saying, well, Choya is moving around with Void Rays. Why is he moving those Zerglings around? They could get caught. Well, he actually just wants to know where the Void Rays are. That's why he keeps running those Zerglings around. He's okay losing three or four of them when they run into the Void Rays, because he just wants to know where they are.
Yep. Plus one weapons are coming for Choya as well. He's just sending his probe in to see what's down here at this third base, keeping an eye on these Void Rays in the middle of the map.
Unstable, we'll get a shot of it in a second. The Warp Prism has three sentries inside of it. He's going to drop those sentries into the main, then force field his opponent's units outside the main.
I love it.
As Zealots run in here, he's going to draw the units towards this base while he has the Zealots here. Then he's going to force field using those sentries inside the Warp Prism to trap his opponent's unit outside the base. This is genius by Choya.
He is going to lose all those Zealots down at the third, but here come the Void Rays. He's going to be able to keep that ramp force fielded for so long. All those sentries have a heap of energy. The Void Rays are now charged, trying to get out of the range of that Spore Crawler. One Queen goes down, one left, and this could be it. He's still stuck out of the ramp. There's four Queens trying to get up that ramp. So many drones being roasted here. He's also going to be able to take out some tech structures as well. More force fields going down. This has got to be a frustrating point for Czech.
Oh, it definitely is. A lot of those sentries just had so much energy because they've been building it up for such a long time. Every roach that pops up gets obliterated by these Void Rays. The attack from the Zealots to the south has been thwarted, but this lair will go down. Czech desperately adding Spore Crawlers here. Nice choice, making some Zerglings here. He will finally take out those sentries. They're dropping as many force fields as they can, but it will not save the lair. The lair does fall.
That is huge here for Choya. He's also going to be able to take out that Roach Warrant, and now all he has to do is run away with those Void Rays.
He absolutely can just simply run away with the Void Rays. Right now, supply-wise, it's 84 supply for Choya to 111 of Czech. So even though Czech lost that lair, he has made a lot of units. There's so many Queens out here.
If he can get this spawning pool as well, it would actually be a nice trade, but there's so many Queens here.
Yeah, Czech has really prepared, making so many extra Queens just to be ready for something like this. Right now, Choya still has no intention of taking a third base. He actually hasn't added any more gateways. He's still just at the 6. I thought maybe he was going to add, maybe go up to 8 and just make only gateway units. I like this harassment, though, with the Zealots. If Choya continues to attack this hatchery, eventually it will be so low that it will fall.
It's actually just a bit unfortunate because Czech moved his units out, saw them warp in, but I just don't think it was that much on the screen for him to notice on the minimap. But that hatchery is very low health. I wouldn't be surprised if we see Choya go and try and snipe it with those Void Rays.
Yeah, he's actually starting to get so many units out right now. He did add a few extra gateways, but during all of this, he did tech up 2 Colossi. He's got 1 Colossus out right now, and he's got range. Actually, 2 Colossi out. One just popped, and range is almost done. It's going to finish by the time he attacks this base, and there just aren't enough units for Czech to be able to hold this, I don't think.
Well, they are sitting about roughly the same supply, 125 to 116. It looks like Czech is now trying to get rid of this pylon finally, and as more Zealots are warped in down at the bottom, he really wants to go for this hatchery, going to split up his attention yet again, going for the third base, as well as moving in at the natural here. Lots of Stalkers, lots of Void Rays as well. There is 6 Queens there, so if he can transfuse, he might be able to get a couple of the Void Rays, but here comes Choya straight in. There are a lot of Void Rays, Overlords in the wrong position. All these Queens trying to come up from the bottom. Roaches as well. The Void Rays are being taken apart here by the Queens. Transfusion's going down here for Czech as well. Focusing down the Colossus. Nicely done. He's actually got a lot of Lings being popped as well in production. There's 28 Lings popping now, but I don't think he has enough Queens to deal with these Void Rays. They're getting a little bit of pathing stuck.
I'm not sure, man. I think he might hold this. The Void Rays are charged. He's got so many Transfuses, and the Zerglings and the Roaches overwhelm the Colossi, and he will hold this.
Wow.
It looked to me like you were right. I was just like, no, he's not going to hold it, but... No, he just had so many Lings. Transfuses, and then the Lings popped at the right timing. He's going to keep this hatchery alive as well, it looks like. Does keep that hatchery alive. Zealots trying to wear it down. They do have +1, but they will fall just before the hatchery dies. Yeah. Nice defense by Czech.
Yeah, that was pretty clutch timing on those Lings coming out, and they just interrupted the Queens, doing enough damage that even though he was transfusing, you just couldn't do any damage to it.
Exactly. The Void Rays were charged. The Transfusers were going off. The Speedlings came out. He just didn't have enough Stalkers. Didn't have enough Zealots. Had maybe too many Stalkers in this composition. Didn't engage just right. Got a little too over-aggressive. And now he's going to try to take a third base as he moves out here, but he may not have the army to really move out at this moment. He might want to wait just a little bit longer. Turtle up a little bit. Re-max, because, I mean, he did a lot of damage regardless.
Yeah. Well, if we have a look, he is only about 10 workers behind, but taking that third base is going to be huge for him. Czech has had that third base up for quite a while, and he's probably looking to take his fourth sometime soon.
Yeah, most likely. More Zealots are going to run in here. They may actually be able to target down this hatchery. Czech has really neglected keeping this hatchery alive. The Queens are going to try to block, but I don't think they can.
Transfuse.
Nice transfuses, getting those just on time, and it looks like he will hold this. Clutch transfuses from Czech here today in this match.
Yeah, I'm surprised he hasn't put a Spinecrawler down there just to reflect that a little bit. Looks like Choya is trying to take out as much of this creep spread as he can, doing a good job of it so far, and he might actually catch a lot of these Lings out of position, losing a lot of Lings there for Czech, not what he wanted to do, and looks like Choya going on the offensive yet again, really wants to kill this third.
He really does, and I don't blame him. It's very low on hit points. He's going to catch a lot of these Queens at the very least. Queens falling very quickly. The third is going to die, but drones have been pulled, so he will, of course, keep those drones alive. A lot of units about to pop out. They are all Zerglings, and when those Zerglings pop, they're going to die very quickly to the Colossi if they're not pulled away immediately.
We have Choya defending his third base here from a Ling counterattack. Nice warp in by the Zealots. Gets the hatchery and just backs off. I love the move by Czech there, by Choya there.
Yeah, really smart moves by both of these players. Nice holds by Czech, but Choya's aggressive style may end up winning out here after he's destroyed that third base. The economy for Czech is looking pretty bad.
We do have Muters out on the map now, going to try and do some harass, but it's going to be difficult when there's such low numbers. We do have Choya moving yet again straight into the natural. We're looking at a 142 to 128 supply, and he's actually force-killed quite a few units, and Queens dropping left, right, and center now. He's actually taking out this macro hatch. Oh, another Ling run by coming through with the Muters this time, so we will be able to take out this third base here for Choya, but it comes down to can he defend the actual attack at his natural.
It's going to be a base race. Pretty much as simply as you said it, can he defend? And he's actually going to go home here, which is not a good idea. It's not the right choice to go home, because if he goes home, he's not sending his units all at once. He could lose all these Stalkers, but looks like Czech does not want to engage just yet.
Oh, a nice surround on all those Stalkers. The Zealots and Sentries are completely out of position. There goes the Force Fields. There's too many Muters in the air there, focusing down the Sentries, and a lot of Zerglings really... The Colossus coming
That's
through again.
That's going to
be it,
man.
But he can't...
He lost all his Stalkers. Yeah. Those Muters are just going to kill everything now. Should not have turned around. He didn't send all of his units at once either when he turned around. I mean, there are still some units destroying Czech's base, But it's going to be so easy for Czech to just get a few more units out and kill that army.
And these poor Colossus sitting in the middle here, just nothing they can do about it. Two of them drop, and the Muta count now is getting really high.
Yeah, they're
I think he's just going to engage and clean this
exactly.
up.
Exactly. There are just too many units. The Mutas will kill all of those Stalkers. Stalkers do have plus one, but it's just not going to be enough. The Zerglings as well, just kind of bugging out that AI. The Stalker's not targeting the Mutas, and that's it. Loses his entire army, and now Czech can essentially do whatever he wants. He's retaking bottom left location, or he's retaking the bottom left location. He's adding even another one down there around the 7 o'clock position. Choyet lost his entire natural. He's starting to get pretty close to being mined out in his main. He doesn't have an army to speak of. He can't move out on the map anymore.
No, but that being said, Czech's main army is this Mutalisk count. He's already got Phoenixes on the way to try and deal with that. But given the fact that Czech has taken those extra two bases down on the bottom left, he should be able to take this one down eventually.
Yeah, and it looks like that Stargate itself is going to fall. So Phoenixes may come out here to try to defend, but will they be enough? At least it is enough to scare Czech away. And when you have good Phoenix control, especially with Stalker support, it's almost impossible to get a Zerg player to want to engage with it. He's just going to be too afraid.
Yeah, and he is, definitely.
Just not worth it.
Sometimes Zergs do fake running away and then just instantly turn around to get a couple of hits off. But once you get to a certain point of Phoenixes, it's just not worth it anymore.
Yeah, you just want to like right-click your Mutalisk, then press hold or stop, and just repeatedly do that until the Phoenixes eventually start taking a lot of hits. And it looks like the Stargate will fall.
There you go. It does get a couple of hits off on those Phoenixes. Another Colossus comes out of the... out here though, but Choya's stuck on this two base. He can't really go anywhere. The Ling's in the middle of the map. The Mutas are now mobile across everywhere. We've got a Spire going down at the bottom left.
Yeah, he's remade that Spire. Of course, he did lose it during that engagement earlier. And I gotta say, this attack here by Choya could hit a really nice timing. He does have that one Colossus, which will help clean up those Speedlings. The Speedlings very important here. A lot of these Mutas are gonna take some serious damage from these Phoenixes. Oh, is he gonna get it? Does get one Phoenix, but loses about three Mutas in the process. Drones being taken out here, and not only are they taken out, but they alert Choya to the presence of that base down in the south.
Yeah, exactly. He also lost quite a... he also made a lot of drones just before that attack came through. He doesn't actually have anything in production at the moment. He's banking quite a lot of resources here. 1,300, right. 1K. Going for a run by back at home as he does lose that third yet again. There's just so many Lings and Mutas down in this natural. Now he's going to kill so many probes.
And yeah,
there's
he is
nothing gonna, in the main.
There's just nothing right now to defend for Choya. And this time, Choya, I think, is going to realize he can't turn around. He's going to need to start trying to save some probes. He's warping against sentries at home. I'm not entirely sure what he thinks that's going to do against this huge Mutalisk count. He does have his Phoenixes going back. He's going to try to control those.
The Spire's back up and running now for Czech as well. He's going to be able to increase that Mutalisk count. There is quite a few Stalkers and sentries in this mix here. And he looks like he's going straight up into the main, but that's not where the Spire is.
Exactly right. There is no Spire here. He wants to kill, of course, any tech structures he can find. He wants to kill all the buildings here. The problem is he does have these Phoenixes down at his natural, which he's been trying to use to kill those Mutas, but he just doesn't have the Phoenix count that he would like.
And if 13 just... Mutas on the way here. Looks like Czech was actually banking those minerals for all those Mutas.
Exactly. I think that if he can get the Mutas together and take out those Phoenixes, he should be fine. But again, Choya still has a decent Stalker count. If he keeps those Phoenixes alive and uses them properly, he might be okay.
He might even want to just completely wipe out Choya's main here. It might be the easier choice. He does have quite a few bases spread across the map.
Yeah, and actually right now, Choya does not have any probes outside of his base.
No, he doesn't. I don't think he has any probes at all, to be honest.
Check that.
No,
he actually
doesn't.
Has zero probes. So in this scenario, you actually always want to go home because there's no way for you to win a base race if you just can't hide buildings. But on the other hand, he may have thought that Czech would get scared, not knowing whether or not he has another Nexus somewhere and back away.
There we go. Looks like Czech just focusing down that Nexus
yeah,
now.
Yeah, once the Nexus falls, you get revealed, and that's just it.
Yeah, here we go. Choya coming in for a last-ditch effort, but I think there's way too many Mutalisks. The final engagement's going to come in a second. Looks like he's just baiting him into the middle of the corner there. Zerglings coming in with the Mutas in from the back. Going to take out that Colossus first and go straight to work on all of these Stalkers. Choya is being revealed. He's even got a couple of Corruptors in there now. And goodbye, Stalkers.
Yeah, the Stalkers will fall. GG!
Nicely done by Czech. Really defending that first timing. So clutch, but it really saved him in that game. I don't think Choya really had a follow-up to that.
The cool thing was, Choya actually knew so many aggressive timings where there were several times, even after he was defended and he lost a lot of units, I thought, oh, there's almost no way Choya can come back. he knew the timings where Czech would get really drone heavy, and he was just like, I'm going to go attack you now. And Czech was like, I don't have any units right now. I'm going to lose my third base again.
But he did do a very good job of defending all that aggression. It seemed like a couple of times there he was going to loop crack under the pressure, but just went, no, I'm going to stay in this one. I need to stay in third.
Yeah, the queens really played a huge role in that one battle, and then later he used those same queens to transfuse the hatchery, and he did a great job overall with those queens, I think. I mean, a lot of Zerg players just don't make as many queens as they could, I think, and making that many queens, the queens actually have an incredible amount of range. They can attack Colossi or Void Rays without really closing the distance that much, because they will use the anti-air attack, I believe, on the Colossi if they're too far away. So.
I did like the timing of all those leaves coming out, and he actually focused down the Stalkers to not allow Choya to actually take out those queens, because if he was able to do that, the Void Rays would have been able to sit there for as long as they wanted, because there were no queens in production at the time.
Yeah. That was just really, really awesome decision-making control. The Lings came out that perfect timing, and he was able to kill those Stalkers. There's a shot of Choya. I think he's probably a little bit frustrated with how that game turned out, but I think it's not going to... You know, he's one of those guys who doesn't lose his cool.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. He's a very confident player, and this is what he needs. He needs confidence right now.
And it's almost like... I don't want to say he barely lost, but he, even though his timing attack completely failed... I mean, I don't want to say it completely failed, but it didn't do as much as he wanted. He lost the sentries. He lost the warp prism. If he had not lost that warp prism, things would have gone completely differently, because he would have been able to have so many more units up there. The sentries would have stayed alive a lot longer, could have even made more sentries. That kind of situation turned out badly for him and ended up getting behind, but still, he just knew the timings where he could attack, and I bet he's sitting there thinking, you know, if I had played just a little bit better, that would have been an easy win for me.
Yeah, there were a couple of times where it looked like it would go either way, very back and forth game, and I think that's going to play into the mindset of both these guys in this next set, which looks like is going to start right now.
Yeah, countdown has started. The map is Crevasse, so we'll see how Choya's PVZ style works out on this map. I think this is going to be a good map for him. The map is loading. Maybe we'll jump into it here in a second. I don't know. It took a little while last time. So
we'll see how we go.
Yeah. So this is game two, by the way. This is Code A. For those of you guys who are just tuning in, I am Wolf, and with me is Unstable. And we're about to jump into this game. Yeah, it's going to happen in just a second.